not the end. This is just the overture, just the beginning. I know you're blessed, but you still haven't seen God's best. Not yet. But I declare and I decree, I prophesy with authority.
Your pastor asks you why he hasn't seen you in church in a while. It happened about a few Easters ago. A friend of mine was walking out of church just ahead of me, and the pastor was at the door greeting him, or greeting persons as they leave, which he normally did. And so he saw my friend and he said, "Young man, you need to join the army of the Lord." And my friend said, "But Pastor, I'm already in the army of the Lord." The pastor said, "Well, I only see you at Easter and at Christmas." And then he leaned in and he said, "Well, Pastor, that's because I'm in the Secret Service." All right. President of the Ranford Port Authority, Steve Rowe, Vice President, Superintendent Moxie, President of the Grand Bahama Chamber of Commerce, Mr. John Rowe, John Swain, President of the Bahamas Christian Council, Reverend Ranford Patterson, President of the Bahamas Hotel Catering and Allies Workers Union, Mrs. Nicole Martin, distinguished speakers, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of sponsors, the Grand Bahama Port Authority, the Grand Bahama Island Tourism Board, Sky Bahamas, Colombian Airlines International, and the Bahamas Weekly, welcome to the Religious Tourism Summit. This summit is presented by the Ministry of Tourism and Celebrate Freeport under the theme, A New Season for Tourism. Before we begin, I'd like to ask you, if you haven't done so already, please switch your cell phones to vibrate or silent, please, so we can be courteous to our presenters. And I would now like to welcome Pastor Philip Munroe to lead us in an opening prayer, and he will be followed by Renato Sweeting, who will lead us in the singing of the national anthem.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Please stand with me as we open in prayer this morning. Bow your heads with me, please. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord God, for this occasion. We thank you, Lord, for the purpose of this gathering. Your word declares to everything, there is a season and a time to every purpose, Lord, under the heavens. And Father, we thank you, Lord God, for our theme, a new season for tourism. God, we thank you for all of our presenters that will come and that will grace this podium this morning. We thank you, Lord God, for all of the wisdom, all of the wealth, all of the ideas, Lord, that you've deposited, Lord, within them. And for everything, Lord, that they will bring to the table, God, this morning. Father, we are here together, believing you, Lord God, for a shift in the economy, not only of our nation, but in particular of the island of Grand Bahama. And Lord, you promised us in your word that you will do a new thing. And Lord, you said, now it will spring forth. And God, we believe in you that we have entered into that now season, Lord, for the island of Grand Bahama. You promised in your word, you said, now I will arise and have mercy upon you because my time to favor you, the set time, Lord, is come. We know you to be a God of seasons. We know you to be a God of purpose. We know you to be a God of timing. And Lord, we believe, God, that for the time, Lord, for the economy of this island, Lord, is now. And Father, we believe in, Lord God, that indeed it's a new season, God, for religious tourism. Now today, Father, we present every person that is here before you. We present and commit every idea, Lord, that is here in this room, God, before you. For you promised us, Lord, in your word that when we commit our plans unto the Lord, that it is only then that they will prosper, they will be established, and Lord, they will succeed. And that's what we're hoping to come out of this gathering, Lord, today, out of this conference. God, we're expecting God's success. You said that you will be exalted, Lord, within the nations, and it is our express desire and intent, God, for you to be exalted, in particular, Father, through religious tourism. And so we thank you now, Lord, for everything that will be said and everything that will be done. And may it all be said and done to the glory and honor of God. May your kingdom come and may your will be done. In Jesus' name, amen.
Lift up your heads to the rising sun, Bahama land. March on to glory, your bright banners waving high. See how the manner of your bearing, pledged to excel through love and unity, pressing onward, march together to a common loft, your
Council. their absence, Honorable Obi Bilchcombe, Minister of Tourism, Honorable Michael Dowell, Minister of Grand Bahama, President Ranford Patterson, Bahamas Christian Council, Mr. Ian Rowe, President of the Grand Bahama Port Authority, distinguished presenters, ladies and gentlemen, a pleasant good morning. Miriam Baird once said, and I quote, "Certainly, travel is more than seeing of sights. It is the change that goes on, deep and permanent, in the ideas of living. A new season for tourism is the chosen theme for today's Religious Tourism Summit. This theme embodies the vision of the founders of Celebrate Freeport Committee and echoes the dreams of the Ministry of Tourism, whom I represent. We at the Ministry of Tourism are confident that Grand Bahama is ideal for religious tourism and has the potential to realize much more as a travel destination than we have done over the many years. As I look around this room, I recognize the faces of many of you who are known to be the movers and shakers of this island's economy. I am also aware that we have amongst us those who are on the forefront of the religious platforms. Collectively, you are stakeholders and the answers to moving our island as a premier religious tourism destination lies within you. I welcome you this morning, therefore, to be creative in your vision of our island as a preferred place for people who seek God at home and in far off places. Ladies and gentlemen, I welcome you to imagine a culture that entices those who seek the greatness of God's handiwork in nature. I welcome you to imagine a destination which explodes with businesses suitable for the lightness of the religious tourist. On behalf of the Ministry of Tourism, the Honorable Obi Bilchcombe, and the founders of Celebrate Freeport, I welcome you this morning. I end as I started. Certainly, travel is more than seeing of sights. It is the change that goes on, deep and permanent, in the ideas of living. You are indeed welcome.
Good morning. Just to adopt the established protocol. We think of religious tourism. Many things go through our mind. Being a Christian or religious country, Christian nation, and being a touristic destination, I think the Bahamas is poised to be, in my opinion, one of those great areas where religious tourism can really take off. In my research, I discovered that the religious tourism industry is a dynamic $18 billion global industry with over 300 million travelers. It's estimated that some $10 billion is spent by North Americans alone as it relates to religious tourism. The Travel Industry Association of America reported that one in four travelers are currently interested in spiritual vacations. The appeal spans the age, but approximately one third of each age group, 18 to 34, 35 to 54, 55 plus, has expressed interest in taking such vacation. And according to some reports, more than 50,000 churches
and religious organization host travel programs around the world, in North America. Few other travel industry segments can boast of such an impressive number. It tells me that the religious market is indeed the market to go after. In the past three decades, people of faith have changed their spending habits and today purchase first-class products and service. No longer are we budget-class travelers. We stay at the best hotels, eat at the best restaurants, we travel in the best cars. This industry is one of the fastest and most lucrative areas in which we ought to pursue. Religious tourism in the 21st century no longer constitutes only pilgrims and missionaries. Rather, in the modern world, embrace many different forms as cruises, leisure and getaways, conferences, conventions, retreats, camps, adventure, volunteer vacations, student and youth groups, and the list goes on and on. According to the Religious Conference Management Association, this segment of the faith tourism industry experienced an increase of 4.4 million attendees, from 4.4 million attendees to over 14.7 million attendees at religious meetings between 1994 and 2006. So how can we in the Bahamas immediately enter or expand our presence in this religious tourism industry? For companies and organizations, the answer is threefold. First, we must take our existing travel products and service and tailor it slightly to accommodate the religious market. Market is your existing religious clientele. In other words, those who already come to us, we need to market and do a better job and consider faith-based travel as very important. I had an experience, and I wish to share it as I conclude. Several years ago, my organization, I am the person here in the Bahamas who is responsible for representing our organization, which is a worldwide organization here in the Bahamas. We had an opportunity several years ago to take our conference from Florida to the Bahamas. And we decided, after a little persuading on our part from the Bahamas, that we would bring one of our conferences here to the Bahamas. After careful consideration, we brought the conference not to Nassau, but to Grand Bahama. We had more than 900 persons at this conference. We didn't get any press coverage. We got no recognition. We got nothing. Ministry of Tourism in Grand Bahama did their best, but I believe it was a national issue that requires more than just what they did on a local level. Because the same group that consists of the entire Florida and the Bahamas meet more than 10 times a year at various locations throughout Florida. We do four conferences every year at the Shingle Creek Resort in Orlando, Florida, which is a major resort in Orlando. My belief is, if we are going to be serious about religious tourism, we ought to do everything in our powers to ensure that those who have the power to bring conferences to our shores are treated with the level of respect that they deserve. Because all we have to do is convince one person, the leader of these organizations, that this is the place to come. And I can guarantee you, not only will they bring one conference to the Bahamas, but they will bring many conferences throughout the years. A few weeks after our conference was over, a civic group brought another group, I believe, to Grand Bahama. And they had less than 300 persons. It was all over the media. With the Ministry of Tourism fully backing. I was very disappointed. Because here I was believing that we were doing a good thing by bringing persons to the Bahamas who can help to enhance our product in the Bahamas. So what is the future of the faith-based travel? What are the expected trends? When we look at what has happened with the Vatican has launched a charter flight service to transport pilgrims to holy sites around the world. That's how important this religious tourism is. I believe that all of this and all that we talk about during the course of our day will translate into one thing, and that one thing is opportunity. For the group travel planners, never before has faith-based tourism offered so many vacation opportunities and choices. I ask us in the Bahamas to take advantage of this growing opportunity that right before our hands. We have everything that we need to make this industry number one. So today, I just wish that at the end of our time together today, we would see the need to improve on what we now do and tailor a lot more of our energies towards faith-based organizations going forward. May God bless us all.